Phil Grime suggests it was useful to think of plants as having three broad strategies: competitors, stress tolerators, and ruderals, CSR. So the stress tolerators are those like this alpine penny-cress that are largely restricted to heavy metal-rich sites like this Calaminarian grassland in Northumberland. But other examples would be species that live in the darkness of a wood or on the shingle of the River Tyne over there, or live under particularly hot or cold conditions. And they have physiological adaptations that means they can grow in that site and other species can't. The ruderal strategy means you're a species of disturbed ground, such as agricultural land or this track. So there's annual meadow grass growing here. It's a classic ruderal species. It grows very quickly, drops seeds, and so can survive very well under this disturbed habitat. And then the third strategy is to be a competitor. Here you're a perennial species that produces a vegetation that dominates the environment, and it's very difficult for anything else to compete. So an example would be this nettle bed or these brambles. So Phil Grime's idea was that you can imagine a triangle, a CSR triangle, competitor, stress tolerator, ruderal triangle, and you can think of individual species as sitting somewhere in that triangle as a combination of strategies. And you can also think of habitats as to what extent they're a habitat where there's strong competition or strong stresses or strong disturbance. And that, I think, is a useful way of thinking about species and thinking about habitats.